So the Bicol region takes steps to promote products and destinations through a trade and travel fair this week. To talk to us about this and MSMEs in the region's DTI Camarines Sur Director, Jay Ablan. Hi, Jay.
Yes, hi, Stanley.
That's good to have you here. Now let's first talk about micro, small and medium enterprises in the Bicol region. Are you seeing full recovery of small businesses there after 3 years?
Yes, definitely. We're optimistic that all MSMEs are recovering from the pandemic. And, you know, as government entity, we're doing a lot of things for them, mm-hmm. Specifically on marketing, because that's what they need right now, to be able to, you know, generate sales and income for their respective businesses and probably to maintain or probably to sustain their employees. And then we're also working with a lot of government agencies, you know, speaking of MSME development, they really need a lot of things. Example, for production, they need to upgrade technologies. That's why we work closely with the Department of Science and Technology. And then when it comes to financing, we work with a lot of financing institutions. Mm-hmm. Although at DTI, we have this small business corporations, which provides lower interest rate and a lot of opportunities for financing programs for MSMEs. We do also work with some private bank institutions, okay, to be able to provide a lot of financing access to our MSMEs. So it's not just a sole DTI undertaking. It's a collaboration, yeah, both by the private and government organizations to bring a lot of development for MSMEs.
Okay, Jay, you know, Bicol has a lot of products. I mean, it cannot just be one town, one product for Bicol, considering the diversity of the products that the region produces. Now, how do you help your MSMEs break the global barriers, encourage them to export these products?
Well, actually, before we do a lot of marketing events, that's a fact. But then before we bring them to the market, we do a lot of preparations. Example, we do product development activities to be able to make our products competitive both in the domestic and global market.
Yeah.
At the same time, we improve also the quality of the products. Example, for food products, we make it a point to make it compliant to the government regulations. Mm-hmm. Specifically, under Food Safety Act, they have to be to have, for food processors, they have to have a license to operate and then the certificate of product registrations. So we make it a point that they are compliant with those government regulations. At the same time, we improve the packaging and labeling to make it more attractive to the market. So we do series of intervention to make our MSMEs ready for the domestic and global market. And then we do also a lot of regional marketing events. An example of this is the Orgullo and Bicol Trade Fair.
Okay.
It is the longest running trade fair managed by a government entity like DTI. Mm-hmm. Example, this coming tomorrow, we will be having 100 plus MSMEs in the mainstream Manila. So we're confident that we can pull it off and we will be able to help our MSMEs generate more sales for their respective businesses.
Yeah, let's talk about Orgullo in a bit. I'd like to go back to what you mentioned earlier about science and technology and digitalization playing a crucial role in businesses these days. We know these are different times, Jay. How are MSMEs in Bicol using science and technology to make even processes easier? Or are they getting assistance from government when it comes to digitalization and trading and doing business in the digital space?
Well, actually, one of the perennial issues of MSMEs is really productivity. Mm-hmm. And I think the way to do that is really to improve the way they produce their products and the way they manage their respective businesses. And I think two key factors there would help them solve that problem. One of which is science and technology. That's why we collab with the Department of Science and Technology, improving the way they produce the products in terms of quality, mm-hmm. in terms of volumes. In fact, DOST has this setup where we collab for MSMEs to be able to access this assistance. Okay. And of course, there's digitalization. We do a lot of training programs to educate our MSMEs on cashless payment and other things sort like that, to be able them to cope with the trends, not only in the domestic but in the global market. And I'm happy to share that a lot of our MSMEs have already they're already doing the cashless transaction. They already they're already enrolled in the online marketing platforms,
yeah,
both in the domestic and global market. Okay. I don't need to name names, but a lot of our MSMEs in Bicol region are already enrolled in the global marketing platform.
Okay, and as you mentioned, you're having Orgulyucan Bicol on October 19. That's going to be tomorrow. It's a display at the SM
yes.
Mega Mall, right, that will last for the entire week. And, of course, you have all of those products from the Bicol region to be featured there. And there is the other side, which is travel. Now, Jay, we have a very long break towards the end of this month, and Christmas break is also just around the corner. What destinations in the region are you heavily promoting or featuring for travelers to explore, and what offers on tourism can one find at the fair?
Yes, first things first, this is Orgulyucan Bicol that we are featuring starting tomorrow. It's a collab between DTI and USD. You know, speaking of Bicol, we have a lot of things to offer. Not only good crafts, good food products, but we also have a lot of good sites where a lot of our guests can visit. Mm. Example, of course, is the renowned Mayon Volcano. Mm. We have the Peña Francia festivities in Naga City. We have the in the Sumlang Lake in Albay. And then in Sorsogon, in Masbate, in Catanduan. So
yeah,
we're offering Bicol region for a lot of tourists. And then, of course, tourists will look for good products where they can buy. So we're also featuring the Pilinat, the Laing, the Bicol Express, and then the Abaca crafts is also a renowned crafts in Bicol region. So there are a lot of things MSM or buyers could patronize in this 4-day fair happening here in Metro Manila. So I hope a lot of our kababayans would really support and patronize this Orgulyucan Bicol Trade Fair.
All right. Again, to close, Jay, invite our viewers to the expo. Maybe give them information that they need to be part of this event. What are the details that they need to know?
Well, starting tomorrow, we will be at Shangla EDSA. We will be featuring 100-plus MSMEs. Of course, we will feature a lot of Bicol cuisines, Bicol products, and Bicol crafts. Of course, I mentioned already the Pilinat candies, the Laing, the Bicol Express. And then we also have some good crafts, bags, hats, footwear, made of different fiber materials readily available in the Bicol region, like abaca, buri, and other raw materials. And then we will also feature some of the renowned tourist sites in Bicol region. Of course, the Sumlang Lake, the different cultural events in the Bicol region, the Peña Francia.
Mm.
So there are a lot of exciting things to look forward to in this Orgulyucan Bicol.
Okay.
It will start tomorrow until Sunday. So I hope you can see a lot of support coming from our kababayans here in Metro Manila.
And many things indeed to look forward to. All they need to do is go. Mr. Jay Ablan, Provincial Director of the Department of Trade and Industry in Camarines Sur, we wish you the best of luck on the fair, and thanks so much for being part of the show today.
Thank you.